if you maintain it well, the M272 can still be a great, fun, good performance engine that can deliver respectable reliability. Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Automotive, here today with a video on the most common Mercedes M272 engine problems. The Mercedes M272 was only Mercedes' second V6 engine, and it was produced from 2004 until 2017. Despite that long production run, the M272 was largely phased out around 2010 into 2011. There are three different variants of this engine, including a 2.5, 3.0, and 3.5 liter variant. This larger 3.5 liter variant delivered up to 312 horsepower, so very respectable performance for the era of the Mercedes M272 engine. However, this engine is also known to have a number of potentially serious issues and isn't the most reliable engine around. Now, we'll circle back to reliability briefly at the end of the video, but for now, let's go ahead and jump straight in and talk about some of the most common M272 engine problems. Number one on the list, we have the balance shaft gear failure. This is a very well-known and well-documented issue, but ultimately, as a 90-degree V6 engine, the M272 does require a balance shaft to help smooth out the engine and reduce vibrations. The gear of the balance shaft is known to wear down prematurely and can be a very costly and serious issue. Because of that, there were a number of lawsuits floating around for this back in the day, and it was a known issue on 2004 until 2008 M272. Two engines. Typically, this issue tended to pop up in the ballpark of about 60,000 to 100,000 miles. So ultimately, I don't believe those original lawsuits went anywhere, since technically that is outside of the normal warranty period. However, because of those lawsuits and really how common these issues were, it is something that there's a ton of information about online and something to be aware of if you are in the market for a 2004 until 2008. Make sure you check the history and really consider this issue, see if the repair has been done and performed properly in the past, since the balance shaft gear failure can be roughly $2,500 to $4,000 to replace this if you run into this issue, and that assumes that no additional damage occurs when that balance shaft gear fails. Moving on to the second common problem, we have issues with the intake manifold. This engine uses a variable length intake manifold to offer the best overall power band and the best of both worlds when it comes to low-end torque, as well as top-end power, so it's a great manifold from that perspective. However, the lever that controls the opening and closing of the manifold is known to fail and can cause serious issues. In some cases, the swirl flaps inside of the manifold can come off and actually be pulled into the engine, potentially damaging intake and exhaust valves on their way through, or potentially even damaging the pistons. So if that does occur, this can be an even more serious and costly issue. However, in the case of the manifold failing, you will just have to replace the manifold, which is generally a $600 to $700 part, and it does require a few hours of labor to get the job done. So if you go to a repair shop, this can be a roughly $1,000 to $1,400 repair job. There are some aftermarket options that can help address this issue, so that's definitely something to look into and consider if you're looking to own an M272 for the longer term. Upgrading that manifold and addressing some of those failure points can be a great option to ensure that you don't continually run into this issue. Other than that, it's generally not a serious issue as long as the swirl flaps don't fail and actually get ingested into the engine. Now, moving on to the third common problem, we have thermostat failure. This is likely the single most common problem on the M272. I know I'm talking about this third on the list, but really, the first two problems were just more serious and more costly issues. Ultimately, the thermostat is a very simple part that controls the engine coolant temperature, and when that fails, that can cause a number of symptoms from potentially overheating to the engine taking too long to heat up, as well as the check engine light. In most cases, it will fail in a position that won't allow the engine to overheat, so it'll essentially allow max coolant flow throughout the radiator and cooling system. So overheating shouldn't be a problem in most cases with this failure, but still something to consider because that could make it more serious, obviously, and make that repair a lot more urgent. Otherwise, you'll just have the check engine light, and again, the engine may take a lot longer to warm up. Fortunately, when it comes to the thermostat, it is only about a $60 part, and it will take a couple hours of labor to replace it. It's a pretty straightforward deal. DIY, so not expensive for any of the DIY crowd. If you end up at a repair shop though, you could still be shelling out about $250 to $400 for this job. Moving on to our fourth and final common problem to discuss with the Mercedes M272, we have oil leaks. One thing I want to mention up front is there really aren't any serious design flaws or issues that cause any premature oil leaks. However, this is a mostly 15 to 20 year old engine nowadays. And so naturally, any kind of gaskets, O-rings, hoses, any rubber or rubber-like materials are simply prone to degradation over the years. So a couple common oil leaks to be on the lookout for include the valve cover gasket, the oil filter housing gasket, as well as the oil cooler gasket. Now that wraps up the most common problems with this engine. So tying it all together and talking about M272 reliability, I would say the M272 definitely earns slightly below average remarks for reliability. Especially the 2004 until 2008 models that were prone to the very costly and serious balance shaft gear failure. Outside of that, the intake manifolds are an issue, and again, that can be a somewhat costly issue, and the thermostat is a very, very common problem, but one that's not expensive or very serious in the grand scheme. And then lastly, oil leaks are just natural for a car and engine of this age, so really not a whole lot to hold against the M272 outside of those early serious issues with the balance shaft gear, but still throw in some other potential issues with this engine, and it's certainly not going to be the most reliable engine around. It's also not the least reliable. Now, that doesn't mean that this engine is a complete horror story. If you maintain it well, keep up with maintenance, use quality fluids, change the oil on time, etc., the M272 can still be a great, fun, good performance engine that can deliver respectable reliability. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.